don't know if it's me getting old and missing all those sort of halcyon days of pump mechanics and dance experiments, but, you know, I think there is some sort of vacuum. I think that sort of initial post-punk new wave thing is over, and maybe people are looking for something else, but it, you know, but like it's, I can't really say objectively because like maybe I'm a bit jaded or something, but I think, yeah, it's a bit depressed at the moment. I can't see any new up-and-coming bands coming through that will probably do the same as what, you know, Dance Experiments or Pop Mechanics or whatever have done, you know.
Here we are in Christchurch, a city famous for its great pop bands. They've been going since the days of Ray Columbus and the Invaders, through Dick Driver's hip singles and even up to Dance Exponents. Well, they've all gone now, but they've left a legacy of many pubs, lots of gigs, and quite a few less commercial but equally as interesting bands. I've got my obligatory copy of the Christchurch Star, so let's see what's on in town tonight.
Tonight, my bet, Zanzibar.
What's on there?
White Boys, local band, boys trying to make good. It'll be packed.
What sort of crowd are we looking at there?
MIBs, Men in Black. Not a great deal of colour. A lot of people standing around. But it'll rage about 10 o'clock.
Yeah. Okay, Zanzibar's a fairly new gig. What about the trad places like the Gladstone, the Hillsborough?
Gladstone this weekend celebrating its 50th birthday party.
Last year or so we've lost to the Hillsborough, probably one of the major touring venues in the country. Has that obviously affected things on your behalf?
It hasn't helped things. Business, it's one of the better venues in the South Island, not one of the biggest for sure, but since then there's been no really big major acts, and like some of the Dance Exponents that have actually come down regularly, or Screaming Memories, Alola, Together, the Mockers, they do really well out there, but they can still do the same crowds in town.
Speaking of the Dance Exponents, obviously, and the Mockers, are there any new potential pop star bands coming from Christchurch?
Well, it's been about 15 months and I think there's probably a couple on the horizon. I mean, we've got bands like Made in China that won the Band War here in Christchurch, which have got an English feel with sax and trumpet. Blues bands, pop bands, you know, very few and far between now.
It's a lot of avant-garde, underground stuff coming up. Again, we're not seeing some of the bands which came out of Christchurch a few years ago, not seeing the colour, the life, the party bands. Everybody's taking themselves probably a touch seriously.
To be honest, most of the bands, mainly they prefer it that way anyway, are simply quite happy to have a regional sort of success and enjoy themselves, frankly. I don't think they're out to be the next Split Enz or the next big international act. They're quite happy just to play.
Not so much New Zealand bands, but I'd like to see more overseas bands coming down to Christchurch, which is almost zilch.
Christchurch needs a major touring act to go out there and sell Christchurch so that people accept Christchurch bands. We've seen so many Dunedin bands lately, and they've been received really well here in the Gladstone and really well in so many other places. It's time Christchurch got out there and said, hey, here we are, because it's been a long time since there's been a Christchurch band gone out and done something.
Like fire, succumbing to desire. Watch out when love is cold. Watch out when love is born. Fire on fire, higher and higher.
Flying Nun seems to have taken basically all the market in the South Island, as far as South Island bands go. There has to be a breakthrough somewhere. There's going to be a breakthrough really soon. because everyone's trying to get out.
Come on, come with me. There must have been something in my fantasy. Left alone in my thoughts, I find nothing in the end to ease my mind.
What sort of bands are big in Christchurch?
The bands that are probably the biggest at the moment are the Great Unwashed and the Bats and probably Bill Doreen and his various offshoots. But they're the ones that are making the most noise, not necessarily the ones that are pulling the biggest crowds.
Bill Doreen has always lived on Christchurch's musical fringe. Once purely a musician, he now pours his boundless energies into a new project, the Blue Ladder Theatre.
It's a natural step forward from rock music, which I was involved in 5 or 6 years ago up till last year, because it was so exciting. And the aspect of working with people, some of whom haven't worked in a theatre before, is a bit like playing in a band where people haven't played before, and you get that same exciting, massive steps forward in a short space of time.
Sketch what is. A red rim on the horizon, and a bride on the wheel, and a bride on the wheel.
We're still doing quite well. We had a bad patch with a lot of the pub owners decided that they could do better with just straight cover bands, and there was no place for local bands to play who weren't cover bands. But now the Star and Garter, the Gladstone, the Zanzibar, they all are having bands who are not particularly well known or are up and coming play there, and so we've got a lot of support. I would say that Christchurch from the pub scene is back where it was. We're actually much stronger, I'd say, in most senses.
Thanks, Rob. And seeing as you mentioned it, let's move across town to Tony Peake's Zanzibar, the new gig in town.
What I want to do with Zanzibar is actually cater for everything, really. Right from... well, the bands you've seen here over the last 2 weeks, like the Bats and the White Boys, Hemoglobins, Lions and Tigers, that's a new band, to latest dance music, really, which is on a Saturday night. But I think that there's room for competition, really. I hope that hasn't damaged the venues, but those venues seem to chop and change so much that... you know, hopefully we're offering sort of a stable alternative.
We searched high and low, but neither the Bats nor the Hemoglobins seem to be playing this weekend. Pity. Okay, let's talk Flying Nun.